Let's make this file here in Windows disappear. All we have to do is right-click the file, click on Properties, and down here at the bottom, you'll see an option for Hidden. Enable it, click Apply, and it's gone. Not even you can see it. I'm sorry, it's gone now. What are you gonna do? Here are the top 5 ways you can hide your files and your folders on your computer. Starting with the simplest methods that anyone can do and ending with hacker-level techniques. And we'll also reverse it. I'll show you how you can detect hidden files. So get your copy ready. Let's dive in. And thank you to HCaption for sponsoring this video. We'll talk more about them later. Have you seen anything more beautiful? Oh my gosh, I'm so excited to drink this. But seriously, all you have to do to find it again is open up Windows Explorer, go into your options, click on View, and enable Show Hidden Files, Folders, and Drives. And just like that, he's still missing. Where'd that little bugger go? Oh, he was playing hide and seek. Now we can also do this. You see this folder? We're not gonna hide it. We're gonna make it invisible. We're gonna rename the folder from Hey, and we're gonna use a special character. We're gonna hit Alt-255 and hit Enter. Now there's no name. And if we right-click the folder, click on Properties, go to Customize, and change our icon to something blank, which they have for some reason, and apply those settings, the folder is invisible now. He's still there. See? Hey guy, we can open him up. We can put files inside of him. Where is it at? There it is, but he's gone. How fun is that? By the way, this is pretty cool because most admins have the hidden files and folders option enabled by default. I always do. This, you really wouldn't notice unless you hovered over it. Similar to Harry Potter and his invisibility cloak, you'd have to run into him to find him. And there it is. Now we can hide stuff in Mac and Linux too. Here in Linux, if I type in ls, I can see Ron Weasley, he's right there. But if I rename him and simply add a dot before his file name, suddenly, he's gone. Even you can't see it. Don't worry, simply typing in ls-a for all, there's Ron Weasley. Now that was visual obfuscation. That's such a hard word to say, obfuscation. Try it. It's hard, right? But now let's talk about misdirection. For example, what if I rename this file to be a, not a JPG, but a TXT? Yep, I wanna do it. And suddenly Baby Beard Chuck is a text file. And when I try to open this, the operating system's like, what is this? I don't know what this is. And we can get crazier, sleight of hand. We can add this to a zip file and then rename that zip file to a PDF. Who's ever gonna figure that out? Just make sure you remember that. Don't get misdirected by your own misdirection. Let's see what happens when I try to open it. Yeah, I just got confused. Let's get crazy. Let's hide that file. It's like a scavenger hunt. Who can find that? New day, new cup of coffee. This method of brewing is called the Chemex method. It's a very manual process, gives you a lot of control over the flavor of the coffee and the quality. And it creates a very clean, clean brew. One of my favorites. It's my go-to in the afternoon. Method number 3, ADS or alternate data streams. It's Windows only, but it's crazy. ADS is a feature of the NTFS file system, and it allows you to store additional information inside a file without changing its size or the primary content. It's kind of like this. Let's say this book is a file. I might skim to the end of this book and store a little note at the end here. My Network Chuck Academy beta tester sticker. By the way, if you want to become a beta tester, let us know. Send an email to academy@networkchuck.com. You know, actually, I might store this note, this sticker, somewhere in the middle. Now, from the outside, this book looks normal. And when I read the content of this book, the content is the same, it's unchanged. The book itself isn't different in size, but there is additional data. This method is a fan favorite of hackers. Let's try it out right now. Oh, my coffee is ready. Let's store some coffee data in this mug and then store coffee inside me, data transfer. So we'll create a new file, call this mysecretstuff.txt. Let's add some secret stuff and we'll hide it inside this text file. Nothing to see here. Now it doesn't have to be a text file. It can be an image file. It can be a PDF. You've got options. And before we try it, watch this. Let's dive into the properties of this file. We'll right click and click on properties. Notice the size is 40 bytes. Notice the created, modified, and access time. In fact, I'll capture that real quick so we can see it again. And then if we open the file itself, there is absolutely nothing to see here. But now let's hide it. We'll launch our terminal. And instead of using PowerShell, we'll actually use command line or command prompt. The commands are way easier. It'll be one simple command. We'll type in, type, specify the file we're trying to hide. So mysecretstuff.txt. We'll do a right arrow and specify the file we're gonna hide it inside. The book, nothing to see here. And then here's the secret sauce. We're gonna add a colon at the end and put our secret file here, mysecretstuff.txt. This command is taking this file and saying, hey, with this arrow, we're gonna output it and store it in an alternate data stream, another reality, another dimension. Wait, is this how Marvel works? Yep, that's how it works, ADS. All right, let's hit enter. File is, well, it didn't do anything special, did it? Like that wasn't a big firework moment, especially since the file is still there. Why? Well, we essentially just copied it. And you know what? Let's go ahead and delete that file. We don't need it anymore because it's stored inside, nothing to see here. Now, by the way, be careful when doing that. You don't want to lose any of your stuff. Now, if I open up nothing to see here, there's still nothing to see here. And if I right-click the properties and side-by-side it with our old properties, it looks the stinking same for the most part. Same size, same creation date. The only difference we have is the modified time, which really doesn't tell a lot. So how do we access this file? Watch this. If I type in notepad and specify our nothing to see here file, but then with a colon say mysecretstuff.txt, do you see that? We opened up a secret file hidden in an alternate reality, an alternate data stream, and no one knows about this. Well, they could, but we'll cover that here in a moment. And we'll cover how to actually get that file back out of your alternate data stream, out of that alternate reality. But let's move on to method four. It's time for a coffee break. But to continue with this coffee break, you'll have to solve this CAPTCHA. I'm just kidding. I hate CAPTCHAs. But did you know that websites don't have to do that? CAPTCHA can be invisible and frictionless. HCAPTCHA Enterprise, the sponsor of this video, does just that. Now, HCAPTCHA Enterprise does a lot more than just CAPTCHA. It's a comprehensive solution for advanced security and fraud protection. We're talking passive CAPTCHA, which, like, what the heck is that? We'll cover that in a second. Fraud protection and bot management. And they can do things like passive and invisible CAPTCHA. They intelligently decide when to present an HCAPTCHA challenge. So if you're a normal person, normal browsing behavior, normal computer, you're probably not gonna be prompted with one. But if you're a bot, if you're a bad actor, sorry, Tom Cruise, or AI trying to bypass HCAPTCHA, they're gonna get you. It's really simple to deploy, just two lines of code. So if you wanna make sure you're not annoying your users while also blocking all the bad bots and all future AI advancements, use HCAPTCHA Enterprise. Check them out, link below, hcaptcha.com/networkchuck. See this sucker in action and start your complimentary pilot today. And thanks again to HCAPTCHA Enterprise for sponsoring this video and making things like this possible. Coffee break over, you are not a robot. Method four and five are kind of tied for most secure, but I had to pick one to go first, and this one is crazy. No one's gonna find your stuff. Maybe not even you. This is encrypted and hidden containers. This will involve storing our files in a container that will act as what's called a virtual drive, which will actually mount to our file system. And we'll use a tool to encrypt this and hide it to where even you might have a hard time finding it. Now for this, we'll be using a third-party software called Veracrypt. It's open source, cross-platform, and awesome. It's not the only one that can do this, but it's the one I'm gonna show you. So whether you have Mac, Linux, or Windows, we'll go out to veracrypt.fr. I guess it's a French company. It's kind of cool. We'll go to downloads, and I'll download the MSI installer for Windows, and we'll install it while sipping some coffee. Now, if you're on Windows, you'll be prompted to disable Windows Fast Startup. Disabling this is totally up to you. The downside is that your Windows computer won't start up as fast. The upside is that you potentially increase the security and usability of Veracrypt encrypted containers. Easy for me to say. I want to say no for me for now, for sake of speed of this tutorial and demonstration. I do recommend you read the user manual and guide. It can get kind of complex. What the heck was that? That scared the junk out of me. My Astro robot was walking around making noises. That was terrifying. Whew, I'm here alone. But a basic setup is pretty easy. First, we'll launch Veracrypt, and we'll click on Create Volume. Again, complex, you have options, but for inexperienced users, like me, I'm pretty new to this actually, I'm gonna create an encrypted file container. Click on Next, and for this one, for obvious reasons, we're choosing the hidden Veracrypt volume. And you're essentially creating a Veracrypt volume inside a Veracrypt volume. Inception. If you want to learn more, click on that link in your setup. Click on Next. Normal mode is fine. And then we'll select our file. Now, this is kind of the cool part, because you can kind of choose any random file you want to. So I'll just do a new file. Create a new text file, actually. Just a text file. And we'll use that file as our encrypted hidden container. Oh, I didn't have to make it. I'm going to replace it. Yes. Okay, cool. Now this file can reside anywhere, on your hard disk, which is what we just did now, or on a USB flash drive, or really anywhere. Click on Next, Next, choose your encryption algorithm, I'll choose AES for simplicity. Your hashing algorithm, SHA-512 is great. Click Next, and then choose the file size. Now, how much space do I have on this computer right now? I think it's almost full, actually. I've got some space. I'll make it 1 gigabyte. Why did I look? It said it right here. I need some more coffee. We'll create a password for our outer volume. Keeping in mind, we'll have two separate passwords in this process. Click on Next. Yes. Move our mouse around to make things random. It's kind of fun, but annoying. Come on. There we go. Format. You asked me to get about Windows Fast Startup. No. Yes. And now time for our hidden volume inside that volume. Next, next. I'll make the volume inside that volume 500 megabytes. And then we'll set another password. Next, format, it's been created. Next, actually no, we're done. You could click on exit, I should have done that. I'll click cancel. So right now, this file in my downloads folder, just a file.txt, that's an encrypted hidden container. When I try to open this, Notepad's like, what the heck is this thing? You can't do that. But I can use Veracrypt to mount it as a drive. So right now, look at my mounted drives, nothing here. I'll choose a drive letter, let's say W. Click on select a file. I'll go find that justafile.txt, open that, mount it. It's gonna prompt me for a password. Here's the cool part. If I wanna open the outer volume, I'll put that first password I set up, hit enter, and now it mounted just like a regular drive. This is a virtual drive mounted on our computer, masquerading as a text file. That's wild. If I open that, I can interact with it. Let's put a file here, just for fun. Now let's unmount it. We'll select our drive here in Veracrypt. Click dismount. Now it's gone. Now I'm gonna try and mount it again. Mount. This time I'll put the password in for our hidden drive, the container inside the container, inception. The only difference here in mounting is using the other password. Click OK, and it's mounted. Notice it is a different size. If I jump in there, that file we created in the outer shell is not there. Let's add Babybeard Chuck in here. Perfect. Now we'll dismount, and now no one can see it. If I were to try to mount it again with the outer shell password, if I open that up, Babybeard Chuck isn't there. So the idea is that, you know, if you've been caught, you're being held hostage and you got secret information and someone's like, put in the password, you can never drink coffee again. You're like, okay. And you put in the fake password for the outer shell and it opens up and they're like, what is this? For fun? This is an empty file. Okay, I guess you had nothing to hide. This is essentially undetectable, kind of. There are ways to find out. We'll cover that here in a moment. Method 5 is probably the most fun way to hide anything. And it's definitely the choice of a hacker. It's called steganography, not stakenography, which sounds awesome. With steganography, we're hiding a file inside things like pictures and even audio, like a song. Now, by the way, steganography can be used for things other than media to conceal documents and objects. But in our case, we care about digital stuff. And the way it hides files inside a picture or a song is so cool. We're not gonna get too deep, but essentially it'll use the least significant bits, or the LSBs, to alter these files, to store some data inside, but alter it in a way to where no one would really notice. Like a picture, it might change a few pixels here and there, but it's not perceptible to the human eye. It might change the song a bit, but you would never be able to hear the difference. You wouldn't be able to hear that there's a hidden file inside the song, which is so crazy to think about. To do this, we'll be using an open source software called StegHide. It is cross-platform. Let's try it out right now. Here in Windows, I'll hold on, pause the video. Let me save you some trouble. Installing StegHide on Windows doesn't work. I tried for a minute, so don't even try it. But what we can do is use WSL, the Windows subsystem for Linux, to run StegHide. Recommended choice, please do this. If you're like, I don't know what that is, I've got a video on WSL right up here somewhere. Check it out. So here in Windows land, I've got WSL running. I'll install steghide by doing sudo apt update to update my repositories, and then sudo apt install steghide. Yep, let's install it. Perfect, that was actually pretty fast. Now, unfortunately, on a Mac, steghide cannot be installed without a lot of difficulty. There are other tools for steganography on Mac, like OpenStego, and you can install that with brew, but we're not gonna cover that here. Maybe another video for another time. If you wanna see that, let me know in the comments below. So my goal is to hide my secret diary inside this photo of baby John Hammond. Now there's one gotcha. You have to make sure the file you're trying to hide is smaller than the file you're gonna hide it inside. Otherwise you'll hit an issue. So right now, baby John Hammond is roughly 30 kilobytes, while my secret diary is 62 bytes. We should be okay. So with one command, we'll type in steghide. We'll use the embed option. We'll first specify our cover file with -cf, the file we're trying to hide stuff inside. That'll be baby John Hammond. We'll then use the EF switch to specify the file we want to hide. So my diary. And that's all we have to do. Hit enter. It's gonna prompt us for a password. We're setting that password now. Coffee. Oh, you gotta type it in right. Okay, let's try it one more time. C-O-F-F-E-E. C-O-F-F-E-E. And that was remarkably fast. Okay, it's in there. Now one thing, one gotcha is if I go up here and refresh, my secret diary is still there because essentially all we did was copy it inside. I can delete this now. Secret diary, you're gone. And now if I open up John Hammond, baby John Hammond, somewhere in this file, I'm gonna say probably John Hammond's hair. Somewhere in his hair is my secret diary, but you would never know. We can extract my diary with one command. Steghide, extract. We'll use the -sf switch and then specify our cover file, which was baby Hammond, baby John Hammond. Hit enter, put our same password in we set before, coffee, and it should have done it. Let's go refresh. There it is, my secret diary, safe and sound. Now let's put it back in there. Back in there, I want to show you one more thing. I want to put this Baby John Hammond image, which contains my diary, I want to put that inside a WAV file, a song. Actually, you know what? Let's do a recording of the video we're making right now, Inception. I'm gonna go grab it real quick. I'll do the last video file I had. This one's pretty big, 212 megabytes, so no problems hiding John Hammond inside there. Let me change the name so it's easier to play with. And let's put John Hammond inside there. This is kind of crazy. Let's take hide embed, -cf, it'll be recording.wav. And then our embedded file, -ef, will be Baby John Hammond. Put our password in. It's taking a minute. I'll sip some coffee while it's doing that. And that's it. I'll go delete Baby John Hammond. And now inside this audio file, which, you know, let's try and play it.
Inside a Veracrypt volume.
Sounds like me.
Inception.
But you'd never know that a picture of John Hammond is inside that file. And inside that picture of John Hammond is my secret diary. Let's see if we can extract it. I want to make sure this actually works. So we'll do seghide extract -sf and we'll do recording.wav. Okay, Baby John Hammond, there. Now let's extract Baby John Hammond once more. Oh, that is so stinking cool. Now, okay, probably one of the cooler ways to hide a file. But like most things, it's not foolproof. So now we're at the section of the video where you can detect hidden files. Are your kids trying to hide things from you? The answer is yes. So what are some techniques to find hidden files? We'll go through each of the five methods right now. Now the first method, simply hiding a file, is great. It's simple. Anyone can do it. It's just a function of your basic file system. And if you're trying to hide your files from non-technical people, this will work. But by simply enabling show hidden files and folders, they pop right up. Or in Mac and Linux, just typing in the -a switch will show you every hidden file. And you can easily search and discover hidden files with some scripts, like this one here in PowerShell, or this one here in Linux. Now for method two, when you rename a file to misdirect, so for example, renaming Baby John Hammond to coffee.pdf. This again is pretty great for tricking non-technical folks or even technical people. But if you're really on the lookout, if you're trying to find hidden files and you want to discover this method, you can do things like this. This PowerShell script here will look through a list of files and tell you if something is a JPEG image hiding as a or masquerading as another type of file. So I specified text files. Let's try specifying a PDF file. And sure enough, looking at that coffee.pdf, it's likely a JPEG image because it'll look for kind of file signatures, footprints, or what a file normally looks like. It normally starts with things like 0xff or 0xd8. These are well-known things. You can do the same thing in Linux with something like this. Yep, coffee.pdf is actually a JPEG image. What about method three, alternate data streams? Hiding a file in another dimension here in Windows. You're tricking a lot of people who don't know what ADS is, but with one command, you can discover the alternate data streams. In fact, it's pretty easy. Type in dir, which will show you the listing of files. But if you add one more switch, dir/r, it will actually reveal to you the alternate data streams. And here, Baby John Hammond is hiding, nothing to see here. And then I didn't realize I did this earlier, nothing to see here is hiding my secret stuff. Now method four, encrypted containers, that's pretty hard to discover. Because I mean, if you look here, my downloads folder, just a file.txt looks like just a file. But notice something kind of interesting. It's a bit larger than a regular text file. And normally an encrypted hidden virtual drive will be larger than that. So on Windows, you might run a script like this or a command that will list all files that are kind of large, larger than 100 megabytes, and look for anything out of the ordinary, like this text file. Why is he larger than 100 megabytes? Now here's the kicker. Sure, I found that, but I can't get to it. I need the password to open it. And also, I probably don't realize there's another hidden vault inside that one. So method four, pretty bulletproof. Probably the go-to option if I were really, really, really trying to hide something. Now method five is also a pretty good stinking option. You're hiding things in plain sight inside a photo, inside a WAV file. And because we're usually using the least significant bits of a file, the alterations are very minimal. So even visually or just technically, it doesn't look like the file really changed at all. Of course, that depends. We can use tools like Steg Detect that will actually look through images and files, trying to find any traces of steganography. And while it's still pretty hard to find, it does leave a trace. Five methods to hide your files. If you want to go crazy, you can use all five in one go. Hide your files, rename them, put them inside an alternate data stream, hide them inside a photo with steganography, and then put them inside a virtual container with Veracrypt. Actually put it inside a hidden container that's inside a container, encrypted with the password. No one's ever going to find your secret diary. They never will.